is there a picture of her, Steve Emming, in the article?
No.
Because I mean, usually I can tell by a picture.
Yeah.
Whether somebody is trustworthy or not.
Yeah.
So I'm curious.
And nobody can now, it may be that she's just wants people to think she had the winning ticket.
Yeah.
There's no way they can prove it, really.
Yeah, there's no way she can prove that she had the right numbers. Unless, of course, the only way that you could prove it, Steve Emming, is the video feed from the store itself from November the 11th. Was it the 11th?
14th.
14th of November.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing the store doesn't have video
if it was sold at a particular time.
Right.
On that particular day.
They would know that.
And she is shown in the store.
Mm-hmm.
But I still don't think...
Well,
it still might be tough for the lottery people to give her the money.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to be enough for her to win. Hey, she's out the $26 million. And you know what? I got to tell you. Does it tell her what her tell us what her name is?
No. I don't think she wanted people to know.
Let's just call her Jenny.
Her name
Jenny, I can relate. You know what I mean? I've been on the verge of $26 million a few times in my life, too.
Yeah.
And it just hasn't quite worked out.
Okay.
So, the United States is trying to figure out what's going on with their mystery syndrome near the White House.
Yeah, that's kind of weird.
Yeah, we've talked about it in the past just a little bit. They're calling it Havana syndrome because, remember, I don't know, was it 10 years ago or less?
Yeah, those diplomats from Cuba had
They were getting headaches. They were getting nausea. In some cases, they had brain damage. They had sleeplessness, which went on. Most of it went away after a week, though, okay? It turns out there's a handful of cases that are happening right near the White House.
But how do we know it's the same thing?
Oh, we don't.
Because people, I saw a list of several things that, you know, headaches, fatigue, you know, dizziness, so forth. But, I mean, that could happen from other things, too.
That is true. That is true. In fact, I had that effect on some nice young lady one time when I took her on a date.
She
said, I got dizziness. I have fatigue.
Yeah.
I feel sleepy all of a sudden.
At least with her, it wasn't a mystery. It was,
that is true.
Yeah.
It was, well, anyhow, we don't know what is going on there. And they're investigating, and yet they haven't figured it out. Now, some diplomats and other government workers in Cuba, Russia, China, and elsewhere have had episodes like that, too.
Yeah.
That led to chronic headaches and brain injuries. Some have had sudden vertigo. Even that's when you get all dizzy there, Steve.
I think it's UFOs that have caused
that's
it.
A possibility. It's a possibility. Although now I have a friend who had sudden vertigo, and it turned out, Steve, that she had water in her inner ear.
Yeah.
And that was what causing the vertigo and some nausea, which would make perfect sense. So maybe they just have a big old outbreak of water on the inner ear over there.
It could be.
Yeah.
Our Idaho buddy's got another Guinness record.
Man, this guy is
busy. I don't know if he has a job. He just seems to keep
breaking records. I wonder if he does have a
records,
job.
Yeah.
Anyway, maybe I need to be this guy.
David Rush is his name.
Mm-hmm.
He's broken more than 150 Guinness records.
Right.
And his latest one is another one he can have. I'm not going to try to beat it.
Okay.
How long can you balance a pool cue on your forehead?
Oh, man. I don't know if I can do it at all.
Yeah, I was
gonna
say.
Maybe once I got good at it,
and even
30
if you could,
seconds or something.
How long would you want to balance
I mean,
pool
I might have better things to do with my time.
Yeah. 2 hours, 16 minutes, and 20 seconds.
Man.
Yeah, balancing a pool cue on your forehead. 2 hours, 16 minutes, and 20 seconds.
Do you suppose that somebody from Guinness lives at his house?
They better, because they always have to check on him.
They maybe rotate it out. It's like, yeah, okay, you're on duty at David Rush's house this month. All right? And they probably got an office pool going on to see how many records they're going to record during the month that they stay with him.
Yeah.
And I wonder if he wakes up every day and says, I'll just try this one. All right? Here's what I'm going to do for today. All right? I'm going to see how many crickets I can catch in my mouth as they jump off the TV.
Well, whatever there may not be. You might want to try that. Well, be the first one.
Could be. I could try that.
That's
one.
Right.
I might be good at it. I might be good. You know what? The experts. I often say, Steve Emming, the experts are often wrong, which makes me wonder why they're experts, right?
Yeah.
But gray whales were thought to be extinct in the Atlantic Ocean.
Uh-huh.
However, Biologists have found a whale. They've named him Wally. They've been tracking its progress since it made its ways into the waters separating southern Europe and North Africa. After first being spotted off Morocco, it passed Gibraltar, made its way as far as Italy, then doubled back along the French and Spanish coast towards the Atlantic, cut off from its usual food sources and growing thinner with each sighting. Researchers worry whether the whale will survive, partly because they didn't think there was any of these blasted things left, and there does happen to be one. But he's not where he should be. Now, the people, that would be humankind, Steve Emming, were to blame for the fact that there aren't very many gray whales because, well, they're really rich in blubber and oil. Mm. And there was a time when they were hunted for their oil and blubber. Now, there's not many left. However, other sightings of gray whales have been seen in recent years, so they are not totally gone. And that's good news right there.
Is it possible that he's just a blue whale who got old and turned gray? I mean, it happens to all of us.
It is possible, Steve. Yeah. I mean, I don't think that's the case, but you never really know.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting if they track him. Now, some are worried that he's gone there to die.
Yeah.
Right? He's gone there to die. Others are saying, well, geez, it's the melting polar caps that's confused him. He doesn't know where he's at no more.
Yeah.
Well, the good news is you can thank John D. Rockefeller for saving the whales, Steve Emming.
I can?
Yeah, of course. Big Oil for saving the whales.
All right.
No one has done more to save the whales than Big Oil. Nobody has done more.
Huh.
Because there was a time when whales were hunted for their oil. And people used whale oil to light their homes. And now they used kerosene after that.
Kerosene whale of a job, John D.
The whales. 570 WNEX, it is the Drive Time Show. Coach's Show coming up.
It's like I blinked and suddenly all my business shifted to e-commerce.
Now my business hours are whenever my customers need me.
My customers want everything now and faster than ever. It's a whole different world.
Your business is changing. The United States Postal Service is changing with it. We're bringing you fast, reliable shipping nationwide. And we're bringing it right when your customers need it. Let's discover new routes. Visit usps.com/new routes. The United States Postal Service. Priority, you.
$10,500 now, $500 now, $11,000
now. WestRac and Blandon Auction will be featuring an online-only construction sale closing May 18th at 5 p.m. This sale includes a 2003 Kobelco SK210 excavator, a 2001 Komatsu D61 bulldozer, a Ashland 13-yard dirt scraper, a 1994 Freightliner semi, a 2001 Trail King Detach 53-foot trailer, and a Topcon laser with tripod stick and magnetic sensor. For more information and pictures, visit westeratkins.com.
This is J.R. of Iverson's. The new cars are coming in slowly, but lots of people are looking for good, clean, pre-owned vehicles, so we're paying premium prices to get them. If you're not in the market to trade for a vehicle, we'll just buy yours. Seriously, we do that. We give you top dollar when you're not buying or trading anything. We'll handle it all with no hassle appraisals and top dollar. It's what you can expect from Iverson's customer first service. Visit us at Iverson's in Mitchell and Huron or online at iversonauto.com.
Valley Ag Supply in Gayville and Spink has a fantastic team that works around the calendar all year long to bring about the best crop outcome for their clients. Not only is their culture a strong and reliable one, but their services are strong and reliable as well. Along with their precision agronomy practices, fertilizer application, crop input, and weed control, they also have hay tarps for sale. Plus, they do hay and nitrate testing. Their goal is to always have your back. Working as a team. At Valley Ag Supply, many on the team have been with the company from the get-go. They know their clients. They know their products. And they remain committed to working with you as a farming partner. Stop by or give them a call. Valley Ag Supply in Gayville or in Spink. 605-267-3100. 605-267-3100. Valley Ag Supply.
This is WNAX Yankton. Check out the impressive capability of the Ford F-150 at buyfordnow.com.
at 6 o'clock.
Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. This is the John Stiegelmeier Show, presented by Covey Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original, and your Jackrabbit headquarters. Also brought to you in part by First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Believe in Possibility, Member FDIC, Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org. Bud Light. Whenever there's a Jackrabbit game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. First Bank and Trust. Because everyone should play hard and bank easy. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. Here is your host, Tyler Merriam.
Hi, friends, and welcome to our season finale of the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. Wherever you may be joining us via the World Wide Web, YouTube, or throughout our Jackrabbit Sports Network of affiliates, we are live inside the President's Suite here at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium inside the West Tower. I'm Tyler Merriam, the head coach of the SDSU football team. John Stiegelmeier is with us, and Coach, this show today has to be kind of a mixture of things because there is so much excitement about what did occur reaching Frisco, Texas, the national championship game. But when you get on that stage, the goal isn't just to get there, it's to win it. And to come oh so close, there's nothing tougher in sports than losing in the final minute of a game. And so all the excitement, all the adrenaline, all the emotion, it was a draining Sunday afternoon for all of us.
Yeah, it's been draining moving forward, too. I mean, it's been very emotional. I talked to different people today, and, you know, I deal with primarily two populations, those outside the locker room and those in the locker room. And I hope nobody takes this wrong, but I've got to invest into those that are in the locker room. And that was a tough locker room. When we went in, and we had a team meeting today because I want guys to be able to scatter and get home. So we kind of had a tough meeting again today, this morning, and kind of said goodbye again to Preston Tetzlaff and the great contribution he made, but just revisited the game a little bit and moving forward. So, but excited, proud that we got there and did expect to win the football game. We just didn't get it done.
23-21 the final, for those who don't know. We're talking like everybody watched the game, and we hope you did, but for those who may not have been able to tune in live, 23-21, Sam Houston wins the final score and scoring the winning touchdown in the final minute of the game. And the one thing that stood out above everything else was Jackrabbit Nation out in Frisco and the events in the 24 hours leading up to the game, a huge alumni function that Andy Foberg and her staff put on, a great turnout. So many former Jackrabbit football players. I know you talk about that, over 1,000 living alums of this program. So many turned out, and not just from the last 5 years, not just from the last 10 or 15, not just from the John Stiegelmeier era. I mean, the Bill Matthews is, and you go back to those guys who from the 70s, Bill was there, of course. So many people came out, whether they were former players or just Jackrabbit fans. And that stadium, so many people have told me it was 2-1 Jackrabbits. The noise, the atmosphere, it felt like a home game at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium.
It did, and very appreciative of that. I mean, they were into the game. They were into the pregame festivities. We did our walkthrough. There were a number of parents that lined were along the fence, cheering and so on. Let's not forget driving out of Brookings I don't know if you're aware of that, but the great support and turnout we had from employees at SDSU to the foundation to the elementary school, the people downtown to the middle school, you know.
You had a parade going out of town.
Right, and Jimmy Rogers said something really cool. You know, he talked Sunday morning to the team and was talking about driving by those elementary kids, and their dream is to be you.
Yeah.
And he pointed to Preston Tetzlaff. That was Preston Tetzlaff however many years ago. His dream was to be here, and he's living it out, so let's play for him. So a lot of neat things outside the locker room, and very pleased with the support of Jackrabbit Nation. You know, let's go, and I hope they understand this, because I tried to at the end there when we were kind of suffering through the trophy presentation, not being the team. I walked down the stands and tried to say thank you to the noise and stuff, and again they just kept shouting positive things, so it was very rewarding and humbling to us.
And I've asked you this on a couple of different platforms, but this is something that you have strived for so long. I can remember after the first playoff year of 2009 and you saying, okay, the goal is now, it's moving to Frisco, Texas. The goal is Frisco, Texas. The goal is the national championship. And first getting to the playoffs consistently, becoming a top 8 seed, then becoming obviously a top 4 seed, then getting to be the number 1 seed as your program accomplished this year, to finally make it to Frisco. How did reality compare to the hopes, the dreams of what you thought it might be?
Yeah, you know, one of those deals where if you've never been there, you don't know what to expect. Yeah. And I said this in the press conference, hats off to the NCAA, to the committee, selection committee, to Frisco, Texas. Everything was first class. Our guys felt like kings the way they were treated. you were in the hotel, you know, beautiful set up for us. You know, everything was perfect. The facility was great. I mean, the grass was unbelievable. The turf was unbelievable. It was a really special deal. But now, like you said, now we know,
yep,
and we have a feel when there's going to be no tourism in us from here on out. We'll be down there. We'll go to work a little faster.
The teams that have competed in the postseasons this year in various sports, it hasn't felt like a championship environment on many occasions because basketball, for instance, so few people were allowed to be in the gym. It just had a different feel. It felt like a championship atmosphere from how it was organized to the noise that the crowd produced. It was a championship-level effort all the way around.
Yeah, the facility sets it up, the fan support, the noise, the announcer, the way they incorporated things. Yeah. It felt like – I didn't think, man, this is May 16th. What are we doing playing football? I felt like we're at home, and this is a treat to be part of.
All right, now, over the next 50 minutes or so here on our John Stiegelmeier radio show presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, we're going to break down this game that occurred in Frisco, Texas, the good and the bad for South Dakota State. He has a lot of thoughts that may surprise you on this particular game. But in addition to that, and we should go back, there was a long-standing segment when this show was live at Cubby's we would do off the air during a commercial break, and this was your idea. You started this thing.
I can't wait.
Was Jackrabbit Joe, my son, and Stig, and he's raising his hand over here off camera. He has been asking to return, and now that all the protocols are over, Stig said, we got to have Joe on the final show of the year. And so after a commercial, Jackrabbit Joe will make his return.
Yeah, I can't wait, and I know the fans can't wait, so it'll be a highlight.
He's giving a thumbs up. He's clapping off in the distance. Jackrabbit Joe will be up in just a moment, plus a complete recap of everything Frisco, Texas, and the national championship game when the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues here on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Walk these fields for 8 decades. Grow deeper roots here. Know it thrives here. Bring in world-class genetics and innovative traits like Chrome Triple Stack Corn Hybrids and Enlist E3 soybeans. Refine it through pure local know-how and expertise. Do all of that, and the only thing left is the right seed. Hogemeyer Hybrids. Learn more at therightseed.com.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
At Wiffles Hybrids, our family recipe for success has been handed down for three generations. Take two parts high-performing hybrids, mix with one part unmatched quality, then finish it off with our secret sauce, superior customer service. Some people may say it's impossible to get the best hybrids from an independent, family-owned company, to which we say, have your cake and eat it too. Mmm, Wiffles Hybrids, quite possibly the best hybrids you can buy.
The road to success is paved with hard work, dedication, and perseverance. It also requires a strong team and a common goal. First Premier Bank can help you achieve financial success using this same formula. Our associates take the time to know you, and you'll never receive cookie-cutter solutions. Visit firstpremier.com to learn more about our financial products and services. First Premier Bank and Premier Bank Card, proud supporters of Jackrabbit Athletics. Member FDIC.
Stiegelmeier Radio Show presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. I'm Tyler Merriam alongside the head coach of SDSU, John Stiegelmeier. If you're watching on YouTube, you can see a young man is sitting between us now. And
my mom's watching it.
She certainly is. This is Jackrabbit Joe, my son Joseph, who became an internet sensation the past few years. And Stig, you've been asking for this. I don't know who's more excited, you or him.
I'm really excited. Are you excited, Joe?
I'm way much more than you.
Okay. Believe it.
You can't beat my excitement.
Okay, who do you want to ask questions first? Me.
Yeah.
Okay, because you told me earlier today there's a couple of things that you wanted to tell the listeners about.
Yeah.
All right, so first off, the last time that you were at Cubby's, how many cats did we have?
One.
But now we have?
Two.
Okay.
Max and Matt.
Max and Matt. And what do they sometimes do?
They sometimes wrestle each other.
They sometimes wrestle each other. Who wins?
Matt.
Usually it's Matt, isn't
yeah.
it? Yes. All right. Now, you're almost done with school. What grade are you in?
First grade.
You're in
After this summer, I'll be in second grade.
That's right. You will be in second grade. So you are done with school at the end of the week, right?
Yeah.
Okay, then we're going to get into the summer. And what are you looking forward to doing this summer?
Going down the water slide.
Because you are finally tall enough, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you've been waiting to be tall enough to go down the water slide, right?
Yeah, and I can't wait to do that this summer. Hey, look at the windmills.
There are windmills out there, aren't there?
Yeah.
Yes. All right, I think I've exhausted my questions, but somebody else over here would like to talk to you as well.
Yep, Coach Stig. I know Coach Stig.
Yeah, we go way back, right? Yeah. I like you, Joe. Okay. Your favorite Jackrabbit sports team?
Football.
Good answer. All right? All right? I might have to buy you lunch after this, right?
Yeah.
How about this? I heard this earlier. Why don't you share this with the fans? Yeah. What position would you like to play if you were on a football team?
The Jacks.
The Jacks?
Yep. I would like the Jacks team to win because I like the Jacks to win.
Okay. What player position? Do you have a player position you'd like?
Well, I like Big Mike, and I miss him.
Referring to Mike Dom from the men's basketball team,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
What do you want to do on the football field? You want to?
I want to just kick the ball.
You want to be a kicker?
Yeah.
Okay.
And why is that? What's special about being a kicker?
Well, I'm just going to run really, really fast, as hard as you can tell. I'm just thinking about it now as I'm talking.
Hey, one comment. I think we all miss Mike Dom, don't we?
I think we do, yes. I think Coach Henderson misses Mike Dom. I think we all do, yes.
Yeah, I do.
So, did you watch the football game yesterday?
Yeah.
Yeah? And who won? Did the Jacks win?
No, they lost.
But they almost won.
Yeah, just about.
They just about won. Did you like watching them?
Yeah, but I just said they didn't win.
Yeah, we're all sad the Jacks didn't win. Did you just watch the game, or did you listen to anything?
We listened. We said, touch!
There's a lot of people that's like.
Yes. Yes. Okay, so this summer you're excited for?
To go down the water slide.
To go down the water slide. Anything else?
Oh, I know. Go down the go to the water park.
You want to go to the water park to go down the water slide.
Yeah.
Do your cats get to go outside? Are your cats outside cats?
No.
No, we keep them inside, don't we?
Yeah. Bummer. My gosh, what is this?
You see some buttons down here, don't you?
Yeah, what do they do?
Well, this table we're sitting on actually keeps food warm, and so you can change the buttons to keep food warm here in the president's suite.
Oh.
But we don't have them hooked up because we don't have any food over here.
We might hurt ourselves.
Yes, we certainly could, so we didn't want to have those on. What's on your shirt? What is that?
Jackrabbit.
It is a jackrabbit, yeah.
It's pretty cool, pretty cool. You like the jackrabbit, or do you like the SD better? You know what the SD is? Which one do you like better?
The SDSU.
SDSU, I like it. Political answer, I like it.
So. All right, is there anything else you would like to say to the folks that are watching?
Go big, go blue.
Go Jackrabbits.
And who's your favorite at home?
Mom.
Okay, just wanted to clarify that. Good. Would you like to say anything to her, or are you done? Okay, he's done. He's taking the headset off. And
good job,
Joe's,
Joe.
Can you get down?
Yeah.
All right. It's okay. Come this way. I'm going to help Joe down. All right. So that's Jackrabbit Joe, and great job, Joe. That's the longest he sat still in a long time, Stig. So I'll have to have you go over to the house sometime to be able to calm him down. All right, we're going to talk about the trip to Frisco with the head coach, John Stiegelmeier, and the way this national championship game played out. All the ups and downs of this wild affair when the John Stiegelmeier radio show presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill continues here on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Here's a pop quiz for corn growers. Of the top three seed corn brands in the Central Corn Belt, only one is 100% focused on seed corn. U.S. farm family owned and got there without the help of a parent company. Any guesses? That's right. Wiffles Hybrids. Officially making them the grown-up in the field. Wiffles Hybrids. One thing done right.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors' Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
The past year, we've taken some things for granted, such as the importance of a consistent food supply chain, gathering in large groups, and the fall football season. Just as SDSU football is innovating to offer spring football games, so too is the ag industry constantly innovating to provide a safe and reliable supply of affordable and healthy food for your family's table. South Dakota Farm Bureau's game plan is to find wins for agriculture by supporting the industry through policy development and advocacy. South Dakota Farm Bureau, a proud supporter of SDSU athletics. Go Jacks!
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
Let's be real. You earn. You save. You plan. You protect. If you want to secure your legacy, First Bank and Trust offers savvy financial planning from people who understand where you are and where you want to go. We can help you navigate your options and build for the future, whatever that may be. We're big enough to help you plan for tomorrow and small enough to start with today. First Bank and Trust. Real banking. Real easy. Member FDIC. Equal opportunity lender.
30 seconds.
Midco Sports Network is proud to bring fans live regional sports coverage. No matter what this season brings, our goal to provide the best local sports coverage remains.
Oh! Jax, Winicky's got himself open over the middle.
From the field to your screen, Midco Sports Network brings you the best in regional sports coverage.
Touchdown, Jackrabbits!
Midco SN, celebrating 10 years of sports.
First Premier Bank and Premier Bank are the playoff presenting partner of Jackrabbit Sports Network coverage of the SDSU football team. This is the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. He's the head coach. I'm Tyler Merriam. Our show tonight brought to you by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill and our weekly feature from Cubby's. How excited are you for this?
Edge.
The meatloaf sandwich.
Sounds good.
Homemade meatloaf with mushroom sauce, melted Havarti cheese, and served on toasted sourdough bread with a side of brown gravy dipping sauce. The meatloaf sandwich at Cubby's on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. You woke up on Sunday morning, beautiful day in Frisco, Texas in the morning, but we knew what was coming, and we hoped that if it was going to rain, it would just be rain and it wouldn't be lightning, and at least we'd find a way to get through this. But it was heavy rain, a downpour I don't think is an understatement, although you felt it, I did not, but it downpoured, and then eventually the lightning comes and stops this game. The elements, especially early on, how much of a factor did they play?
Well, a huge factor. You know, you saw Sam Houston tried to throw that one ball deep, and they had the kid open, and he couldn't get the ball close to the guy. Throwing the ball was hard, hanging onto the ball was hard. We mess up one of the snaps early in the game because of that. What I think is definitely true, it didn't affect our guys mentally. I don't think they walked out there and said, oh, no, we prepared them for that. Our guys are resilient, and they went out there and embraced it and did everything they could to win the football game.
You build a 7-0 lead after a turnover is forced, and then they have the issue with handling the snap on the punt. Again, talking about the conditions. And so you get great field position, up 7-0, unable to move the football, and then you have an issue with the snap, with the wet football. And, boy, that felt like an opportunity, no pun intended, slipped out of your grasp because you could have gone up 2 scores early and unable to do so.
Yeah, and then you always look back and say, what's the differential at the end of the game? It's 2 points, and there's a somewhat of a chip shot. But we were okay with them fumbling the punt snap, right? But not us.
Yeah.
And I'm not making excuses. It's part of the game. The snap was a little tough to handle, and we just didn't get it done in that situation. But there's other plays in the game, as you know. You've talked to me before. There's a play hidden that would have won us a football game too had we made it.
Those are the conditions and how they impacted things early. But one other thing that I think the conditions had a role in is on that first offensive series, Mark Gronowski suffers what you told me afterwards was a serious knee injury. And so Gronowski hobbles off the field after that first series and puts a brace on his knee and doesn't play the rest of the game. And I have to think, just by watching, because Schmid, their quarterback, we'll talk about him later, he landed awkwardly a couple of times or had feet slide out from underneath of him. I don't know if the weather was the sole cause, but it certainly didn't help on the play Gronowski got hurt.
Yeah, I think primarily as I watched the play, I think it's just the way he got twisted in a pile of people.
Yeah.
And, you know, again, it's the last game of the season. We're going to do everything we can to win the football game. Mark had been very durable, had run mm-hmm. through tackles, and just one of those unique things where he got hurt. But the best part of that story, if there is a best part, so he's out for the game. Playing the biggest game of his career, he puts on the headsets and starts signaling and into the game and helping Keaton Heidi out and didn't hang his head. I mean, there aren't a lot of people in that scenario that wouldn't feel sorry for themselves, and he didn't feel sorry for himself 1 second.
How did it change the game plan going from Mark Gronowski to Keaton Heidi?
Less quarterback runs, probably less, just because of the number of reps, Keaton gets less multiple read type passes. Not that Keaton couldn't do that, but if you don't get the reps at it, you don't want him thinking here to here to here. You want more the naked, throw the ball to the flat or to the comeback, that type of thing.
Sam Houston ties this game at 7 early in the second quarter, and then as you're driving, the lightning comes. And so right about the midway point of the second quarter, the game gets halted for over an hour because of lightning, and it's still downpouring this whole time, so both teams go back to the locker room. And one thing that Jeff Nelson, who was in our booth helping us with stats, asked is, do you think that they'll shrink halftime or get rid of it? And I said, well, I guess we'll have to find out. And shortly after that, word came up that you would just basically take an end of quarter break, use this long break essentially as halftime, and play 2.5 quarters in a row. So essentially that becomes your halftime. But walk us through that process of getting rid of halftime, because I assume that's something that you and then Casey Keeler had to agree upon.
Yeah, well, initially they said, how about halftime? When the first delay occurred, they said, how about halftime being shrunk by 5 minutes? I said, no, you know, it doesn't make any sense. This is just a 30-minute deal, but I think we extended it a lot more than that. I know we did.
That was over an hour.
Yeah, and so then we started thinking, we were just told. We were told this is what we're doing.
Okay.
But, again, coaches are making adjustments, so we did use it like a halftime. Our coaches were very smart because they talked about, with this possibility, let's make sure we have extra food. So we had fruit, granola bars, that jerky. So our guys weren't sitting there getting hungry, because those guys, you got to feed them about every 2 hours to keep their motor running. So I think we did everything we could in that situation to accept it and work through it.
Well, as the game played along, just trying to get an offensive rhythm at times was a bit of a struggle, but that defense continues to rise to the occasion again and again, because this offense is as vast and versatile as you're going to find.
Yeah, they're very good in offense, and 12 is a phenomenal player. 2, I think, is the other guy that's really special, the quarterback special. I was disappointed in how they ran the football in the game. I thought we'd be better than that. But if you have to take care of the receivers I'm talking about, you got to give up something. And then I think their quarterback is a really special player. I know he is. I watched him on film, and he showed that in the game.
Well, it's 17-7 at one point after they hit a field goal late in the third quarter. And by this point, the rain has stopped. The lightning's gone. I mean, the sun is shining, and it starts to get hot and humid there. I mean, it certainly changed in a big way. And then that Jackrabbit offense. I don't know what exactly it was, but, man, you picked up steam and suddenly found a rhythm there the last 16, 17 minutes.
Yeah, credit to our offensive staff. They're really the play that worked a lot, and we ran it a lot, was a play they put in at halftime. And just they gave us a consistent look, an 8-man front look, cover 3 or man. They chose in between the two, and we just felt there was a weakness there. And it was a downhill play, which is Isaiah's forte, and he got a lot of yards with it.
Isaiah Davis was something else in this football game, and he has that 28-yard touchdown run early in the fourth quarter, which brought you back to 17-14. Now all of a sudden it's a one-score game early in the fourth quarter. You force a punt from Sam Houston but got stuck deep in your own territory and had to punt it back, and again that defense comes up, and I can't applaud them enough. And specifically I want to bring up Don Gardner's name, because you pointed out Jaquez Ezard, who was named the most outstanding player of this championship game, one of the top wide receivers in the FCS, and basically it was Gardner against Ezard a great majority of the game. And Ezard made some big plays because he's an unbelievable athlete. But Gardner, time and again, made plays as well. He had three pass breakups officially. And there's a couple of balls, including the fourth down catch in the final drive, that you can't ask Gardner to defend him any better. And Ezard makes a great diving catch to keep the drive alive. I thought watching those two was kind of the game within the game. As a spectator, if you don't have a rooting interest, you couldn't help but just go, man, these two guys are fun to watch.
Yeah, and both are very confident players. So when they made the play, you could tell they wanted to make sure everybody knew, and you got to do that at corner. You got to have great confidence, and Ezard is a phenomenal football player. I told him that after the game, but again, 2 fourth downs in that last drive, make one of those, you're in good shape. You're taking a knee, and it's tough to swallow, to be honest with you. It's an emotional feeling.
We'll get to that in a moment, but I want to take a moment to hit on this. With 6 minutes left in the game, you take over at your own 15-yard line, trailing 17-14 after an incompletion on first down, a handoff to Isaiah Davis. And the initial, it's a pedestrian handoff. You don't hand it off and go, yeah, this is going to go for 85 yards. But Isaiah Davis, it's not to discount the blocking on the play or anything else, but that individual effort by Isaiah Davis. He starts up the middle, ranges out to the left, runs through a couple of tackles, throws a heck of a stiff arm, and then stays in bounds despite multiple attempts to knock him away. That may be the greatest individual effort by a running back on a play in Jackrabbit football that I've had the privilege of seeing. And I may be prone to hyperbole here because it just happened 24 hours ago, but in the moment especially, that was unbelievable.
Well, national championship game, right? Somewhat late in the fourth quarter, on the 15-yard line coming out, and we hand the ball off in second and 10, and he literally – we got some blocks, but he literally had to beat at least four guys along the way, stay in bounds. I know some people – I got an email today from a UND fan, and I tell you what, I couldn't believe the number of USD, NDSU, and UND fans I got communications from. Awesome. Feeling sorry for us and really complimenting us on the year, which really says something about the true value of sport and so on. But he said he should have taken a knee when he got to the goal line. Well, if we're in four-minute mode, we're going to do that. But in the when you're battling, there's no way he would have taken a knee. And it was a big play, and we thought, and like I told the fans and the foundation today, you take the emotions of 5:41 when we score the touchdown to the emotions of 16 seconds left in the game, and as Oliver, our grandson, would say, there's an infinite distance between those two.
Well, Isaiah Davis ran for the longest touchdown rush in the history of the FCS National Championship game. I mean, he literally made history. And then, like you said, to turn it around, Sam Houston, 16 plays, 65 yards, 5.5 minutes. And let's just walk through a couple of things in this drive. It starts, I know you don't want to kick the ball deep to Sam Houston, but you don't want to kick it out of bounds either.
No, we just kicked him in the end zone. We kicked two in the end zone. So do the same thing you've done. And, it's no different than missing a tackle. You miss a tackle, nobody notices the number. Cole Fromm kicks it out of bounds. Everybody's going, what are you doing? He just mishit the ball, and we had opportunities to stop him. We did.
Along that drive, and there's so many plays along the way, but they convert three third downs and a couple of fourth downs as well. I don't know if you've had complete time to process it all. Do you look back at one play on that drive and say, man, if we make this play, certainly the 2 fourth downs, of course, if you don't give up a gain, you know, it's over. But do you look back and go, man, we missed an opportunity on this specific play?
I think the fourth and three, where it was Don versus Ezard, and he got a 5-yard gain. I think that was big. I think they had a third down play where Dyshon was right there, and they threw it up, and he does everything he can, and Ezard catches it. You know, I mean, there's nothing more you can do. That is just a great player making a play. And then we had kind of a mental error, honestly, in the touchdown. and make them earn it. Don't make a mistake that gives you a weakness. Make them earn it.
Well, that's interesting because watching it and not knowing, of course, your exact call, but watching it, and I've seen multiple angles, there are two defenders right there. It is an incredibly tight window to fit the football into, and he throws the ball with some hair on it to Zarek Schmid, and I'm looking at it going, here's a kid who slipped early in the game on the wet turf and hobbled around for much of the game. He got hit time and time and time again by your defensive line and kept getting up. And here he is in the biggest moment, and he threw a seed in a spot where only his guy could get it with 16 seconds left, and his guy made a great catch. That was my perception of that play, but you think there's more to it than that?
Well, yeah, we just one of our linebackers should have been closer to the guy based on his coverage rules, and it's water under the bridge, over the bridge. It's done. You know, we needed to make the play in the fourth down plays, and we wouldn't have been in that situation. And I could have called timeouts there. I thought they were going to run out of time because they weren't using time. They were battling to try to get plays. So it wasn't like they were killing clock. So I kept our timeouts, and with only 16 seconds left, I mean, we didn't have a lot of opportunities.
Well, the ensuing kickoff, Jordan Meacham returns 27 yards, and then you run a hook and ladder, get the ball near midfield, and then call timeout, and now you got 5 seconds. And so now you got to decide, what do you do? Do you try for a quick pass, go down, and set up for maybe a long field goal? Do you run a Hail Mary? Do you try some sort of gimmick play? What was the deciding factor here?
Yeah, you know, I was in favor of the quick pass, but I'm not the offensive coordinator, and we went with a play that is kind of a gimmick-type play, but it's designed for this type of situation to get kind of a pass and a lateral and another lateral and so on, and they just defended it. So it's one of those things that's probably going to work 1 out of 50 times, and that wasn't that one time.
Well, an unbelievable game if you're just a spectator. This is one of the all-timers in FCS National Championship game history. Unfortunately for South Dakota State, it's that bitter pill to swallow. Sam Houston wins its first national championship 23-21 over South Dakota State. We'll discuss this game in more detail, highlight some individual performances, and we'll talk a little about the fall season, which isn't that far away when the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues. Presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill here on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Let's be real. You dream it. You start it. You build it. You grow it. That's what makes this such a great business community. As a community bank, First Bank and Trust is empowered to make local decisions with creative solutions, top-notch online banking, and cash management options. That means no matter the size of your business, we're big enough to help you take your next steps and small enough to get you started with your first. First Bank and Trust. Real banking. Real easy. Member FDIC. Equal opportunity lender.
Spend more moments in the moment, not in pain, with orthopedics and sports medicine care from Sanford Health. Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else holding you back. Experienced care available when you need it, treatment options that go beyond the expected, and a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find your way forward. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org.
Walk these fields for 8 decades. Grow deeper roots here. Know what thrives here. Bring in world-class genetics and innovative traits like Chrome Triple Stack Corn Hybrids and Enlist E3 soybeans. Refine it through pure local know-how and expertise. Do all of that, and the only thing left is the right seed. Hogemeyer Hybrids. Learn more at therightseed.com.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Jax, we are proud of you. Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison is proud to be a strong supporter of SDSU Athletics. We know hard work and determination make for a winning team. So when you buy from Prostrallo's, you will experience our winning team. We will do our very best to find the perfect car or truck and even deliver it to your front door. Find the savings and selection you deserve at Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison. South Dakota strong for 63 years.
Go Jacks!
Looking to gain traction on the competition before the next harvest? Spring into savings with end-user instant rebates, where you can get up to $150 back on each Michelin Ag tire you buy at WW Tire. The best part is, there's no quantity limits, so the more you buy, the more you save. Hurry and get in on the savings, because this offer is valid now through May 15th. WW Tire, delivering fast and friendly service across 8 locations in South Dakota.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is the presenter of our season finale of the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show as we recap what certainly has been a year for the ages in Jackrabbit football for so many reasons. I'm Tyler Merriam, joined by the head coach, John Stiegelmeier, and I want to highlight a few people in this game, and I may miss something, and obviously feel free to chime in, but let's start with Davis. 14 rushes, 178 yards, and 3 touchdowns. And as I pointed out somewhat sarcastically on the air, and to take nothing away from Pierre Strong Jr., but Isaiah was the other back, the non-All-American, and he runs for 178 yards and 3 touchdowns. It speaks to the depth of that backfield, but especially in that fourth quarter, those last 3 runs by Davis, if you make one play, he goes down as an all-time hero. And again, he's only a freshman. You got 4 years left of this game.
Yeah, he had a good day. And again, the turf, I think, was, because of the wet turf, was more geared for his downhill, less cuts. And then he's so strong. You depicted the play about him running through tackles and stiff-arming the guy. And his humility is unbelievable. So he had a special day. And he energized us. His play energized the football team.
Keaton Heidi steps in, and we talk so often about how, the next guy has to be ready or next man up, whatever you want to say. But the fact of the matter is Heidi stepped in, and the moment wasn't too big for him. He certainly puts you in an opportunity to win this game, and to be put in a position like that, that's a tough scenario, and he had you right there.
Yeah, I was happy with Keaton. I mean, I know he'd like some throws back.
Sure.
He had Pierre wide open on the one play and missed it and threw one behind Jackson. But, again, these are humans. These aren't machines. They aren't computers. They don't just hit on all cylinders. And I thought he did what he could to help us win the football game. We're in the lead with under 6 minutes left.
Yeah, you can't ask for anything more in that regard. I thought Tolu Ogunde played a heck of a game for you.
He did. He was in the backfield. He ran down the quarterback at times, and that guy's fast. I mean, he just played with a passion. Again, a senior. I know he's got another year, but you don't know how many times you get to go to Frisco. And he played with a true last play mentality.
One of the neatest parts of the weekend was on Saturday you have a team walkthrough, and before you actually go through the walkthrough at Toyota Stadium, and it's a literal walkthrough. It's not one where you're game plan and you did that later. This is you're just walking through the stadium, getting a feel of it all. There's some media members there to talk to members of your team. And there's a team picture you guys take, and I'm explaining this for the audience because, of course, you know Stig. Everybody sits down in the stands, and before you took the picture, over the PA, they announced the Elite 90 Award winner, which honors a tremendous student-athlete, in this case from South Dakota State, and it's Preston Tetzlaff. And A, how deserving he is of that honor, but B, the entire team and the way that they celebrated him. And I can tell you all the media folks that were there were just blown away by how supportive everybody was, the reaction to Preston Tetzlaff winning that.
Well, Preston is just he's a picture of what it means to be a Jackrabbit football player and probably a Jackrabbit student athlete, really. Mm-hmm. He's a great student, humble, worked his tail off. It was his dream to play at South Dakota State. And there's a little bit in all of us that want to be like Preston. And the coolest thing is he kept thanking the team for what they did for him, and the guys are thanking him. And so it's a mutual respect.
One thing that's interesting in how this year played out, your top passer as far as yardage is concerned is a freshman. Your top rusher as far as yardage was concerned, a freshman, Isaiah Davis. Your top tackler, a freshman, in Adam Bach. And he ends up leading the team with 8 tackles on Sunday. But his surge really in the playoffs started with the NDSU game into the playoffs. Not that he wasn't playing well before then, but it just seemed like that extra time off, whatever little more he needed to go to another level, he got, and he just took off.
He did, and coaches talk about the light bulb coming on or the game slowing down, I mean, when you're the Mike linebacker and you've got to look at all these goofy formations we get and make the call that lines you up and then listen for the coverage check and know where you fit and then know if the line's slanting or know you're fit. I mean, that's a lot for a young man in today's football schemes. And I think you're right, during those 3 weeks and then just his intensity is so intense. He got a 4-point GPA again, along with what we're talking about. He's just so dedicated, so serious, and is going to play a lot of good football for us.
And it does deserve comment as well. In the postseason, your kick return game has really shined. You had a couple of big ones. Davis had a huge one to start the game. We mentioned Meacham's on the last drive, which at least gave you a shot with only two plays. Because if you only go to the 25, you virtually have no shot. He gave you an opportunity. That kick return game was something that really became key for you late.
Yeah, and Coach Schleissner does a great job with that. And, you know, so people understand it. Everybody does different things on the kickoff. So every week you don't just practice the same thing with the kickoff return. You scheme with them. And in this one, they always pinned you. They lined up on a hash, and they always kicked it to that short side. So we always went to the field. And, again, just a great scheme, and our guys executed and did a super job. You know, they lobbed the one time. We didn't get anything, but then they kicked it deep again, and I thought that was interesting.
One other note that you brought up off air as well, you had some issues, two big things. First off, you had a number of false start penalties, which I know you're frustrated with. But then the other issue, too, was we've seen it two or three times this year, getting the right personnel on the field for something like a PAT, and this highlights our special situation.
Yeah, you know, for a PAT, which is the shortest field goal you can kick, essentially, if something's wrong, don't call a timeout. We practice this. We talk about this. Our guys weren't real good at the being calm, but in the excitement of scoring the first touchdown in the game, we had a guy that was on the field leave the field, and then he's over celebrating and he's out of, you know, we talk about getting rid of the static. He had a bunch of static in his head. And so we had 10 guys on the field. We were yelling. We had one guy who ran out. We brought him back. Why did we bring him back? Because all we're going to do is put pressure on our kicker with a short amount of time. And 5-yard penalty, and he kicked the PAT, and then we made some corrections and got that guy's head back into the game.
It's always interesting on a moment like that, because you can do all the preparatory work you want. When you get out on the biggest stage, the national championship game, some are going to be a little frenetic, and they've got to kind of deal with that. Some need that first play or two and kind of work through it. And some, it's just the same they've been the entire time. There's no change.
Well, and honestly, it's like that with coaches too.
Yeah.
There are young coaches that get caught up in the game, and they lose their focus in one or two plays. And the game of football, it's different than that can cost you the game. And so, you know, we really preach talking about being the playing in the present, living in the present in all our positions. And I'm all for celebrating. I'm all for the excitement. I'm past that at my age, but I'm all for celebrating and being in, but then refocus. And that was one of Tom Osborne's wisdom points for me years ago, that they taught their players to do that.
All right, we'll talk more with John Stiegelmeier as we wrap things up on what has been an unbelievable season for Jackrabbit football. Stay tuned. This is the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
At Wiffles Hybrids, our family recipe for success has been handed down for 3 generations. Take 2 parts high-performing hybrids, mix with 1 part unmatched quality, then finish it off with our secret sauce, superior customer service. Some people may say it's impossible to get the best hybrids from an independent, family-owned company, to which we'd say, have your cake and eat it, too. Wiffles Hybrids, quite possibly the best hybrids you can buy.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Spend more moments in the moment, not in pain, with orthopedics and sports medicine care from Sanford Health. Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else holding you back. Experience care available when you need it, treatment options that go beyond the expected, and a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find your way forward. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org.
What does your small business want from a healthcare plan in these changing times? You want employees to have access to the largest network of doctors. You want flexible plans to fit your needs and your budget. But mostly, you want peace of mind, knowing your employees and company will be taken care of. It's why 8 out of 10 small businesses choose Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield. See how we can help you take control. Find your best plan at wellmark.com/business.
Okay, Jax fans, let's make some noise.
Go, Jax!
Okay, Jax fans, normally Keep Farmers Farming Manager Alan Hoyer would be cheering about how South Dakota farmers can secure their legacies for generations to come with a little thoughtful financial planning. But when he's at a Jax game, the only banking Alan does is bank some noise.
Go, Jax!
Bank some noise with us at firstdakota.com, member FDIC.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
30 seconds.
As locally grown organizations, First Premier Bank and Premier Bank Card are committed to the communities they serve. You'll find their associates cheering for the Jacks, volunteering at events, and supporting local charities. You'll also find them helping their friends and neighbors achieve financial success. First Premier Bank and Premier Bank Card, proud supporters of South Dakota State University Jackrabbit Athletics. Member FDIC.
The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continuing, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. Coming down the home stretch, it's hard to believe we have almost wrapped up this spring sports season, and football being in the spring with the head coach, John Stiegelmeier. I'm Tyler Merriam. I say almost because you were the driving force. You spoke to the softball team earlier this week. No, Krista Wood and her program, they've been on the uptick, and what an unbelievable accomplishment. They lose their first game at the Summit League Tournament to add a little drama to it, but they win their next four, sweep Omaha on Saturday, win the conference tournament, and for the first time in the Division I era, Jackrabbit softball headed to the NCAA tournament, earning a number 3 seed within the 4-team Fayetteville Regional, so they will head to the University of Arkansas down in Fayetteville, Arkansas, coming up here this week, and I say that jokingly, but I know that you have particular fondness for Coach Wood and that program.
Yeah, I just first of all, let's phrase this, let's frame this. You make the NCAA tournament, right? Yeah, there's the 64 in basketball, there's the 16 or 24, but the first time you do it, that is an unbelievable accomplishment. That is so exciting for those ladies and for Coach Wood and her staff. And I I've told the story, I jog around them in the mornings and they work their tails off and they wave at me and smile. And so I feel like I know them and just really excited for them. I can only see them getting better, to be honest with you, the way they work.
Okay, now the way you smiled and your enthusiasm when you said it's the first time they've done it, that's what Jackrabbit Nation thought about Frisco.
Well, again, We felt a little bit of that, but we've been talking about this. This has been our goal, and we've been in the semifinals and fell short. And so, I really think I'm going to go back to the Delaware game. The locker room was exciting, but there's been a lot more exciting locker rooms. I think our guys said, we've worked for this, but I appreciate your framing that.
The other point, too, after the game, you were trying to get guys, hey, let's go to the locker room. And very few of them left. They all wanted to stay on the field.
Yeah, I think, you know, said the concept of I'm not taking my pads off the last game. You know, I can't do it right now. And they weren't listening to me, and that was fine with me. You know, and they wanted to feel what it would be like when they do it through Sam Houston, and I appreciate that. And my disappointment was, you know, I didn't get to talk to all of them because we had to keep moving eventually. And I'm guessing there were about 10 guys that didn't hear what I said in the locker room, or more importantly, what Preston Tetzlaff said in the locker room.
Well, Preston, of course, moving on to the University of Nebraska, to law school. Everybody else is eligible to come back. And September 4th, Jackrabbit football will be on the road at Colorado State to open the year. It's a quick turnaround. Give us an idea here of what this looks like here the next 3 months for Jackrabbit football, getting ready for fall camp.
Well, we met this morning as staff, and then we met as a team. And the schedule is June 7th, strength and conditioning starts for the summer. We give them a four-day window off on the 4th of July, and then we give them the last week off before fall camp starts. And then I did something that I've never done before, and I said, if you feel like it's been more of a grind than you can handle, come in and talk to me, and we'll give you some more time off. And I've had a number of guys do that, so I know the toil of this whole number of weeks in a row has worn these guys down, and that I need to keep that in mind because we don't want to wear these guys out.
Now, this certainly is a unique scenario, and we talked about that going into it, how you handle all this. So September 4th is your first football game at Colorado State. Will it be a normal fall camp?
It won't be because it's been changed. They changed the rules in terms of the number of full contact opportunities and half pads, and you can't go pads back to back. So that just happened. That just passed, and I'm fine with that. I mean, this is based on science and facts and so on.
This isn't just for this year.
It's moving
forward. I want to clarify that.
Yeah, because the FBS schools played in the fall, so they had spring ball, and their life's been normal. So, yeah. But again, I'm going to go back to the number of freshmen we played, the number of guys we were able to play. So I think we're fairly healthy.
Well, and again, you're going to have six home games and end up with Lindenwood because of an unfortunate scenario. Not for Lindenwood, but the fact that you don't get to play six FCS home games. You'll have a non-Division I in there. But we think normality will return, 11-game schedule, and we'll be back to having a great turnout again on Saturdays here at Dana J. DeKalb Stadium.
And we need to. You know, that Frisco, Texas group of fans, if we can do that with 15, 16, 17,000, people will come to Brookings, South Dakota. Opposing teams will come to Brookings, South Dakota and leave here going, I've never seen anything like that, because that was really special down in Frisco.
No, it was an amazing atmosphere. We got just over a minute left. Is there something we haven't hit on yet or anything you want to get off your chest, I guess, as we wrap up this spring season?
Well, you know, since you asked, great job again this year, you and your team. I know when I talk to people, they just appreciate so much how you paint the picture on the radio, and you're so professional. And you work, and you don't say this, but I know you work so doggone hard to prepare. And, I mean, I can't learn these guys' names, and I'm looking at their film all day long, and you got them down. And the other thing I'd add, a whole different topic, is we got our grades today, team's grades, and it looks like we're going to have 3.1, which is above 3 again, and really proud of our guys. We had 13, 14 guys with a 4-point or better. So our guys are truly student-athletes.
And no positive COVID tests the entire spring season.
Yeah, unheard of. Really dedicated group of guys. And there are a lot of things that go into getting to Frisco, and that was one of them.
Unbelievable work by you and your staff and the support staff on down the line. Too many to name. But, Coach, it's always a blast. We appreciate your allowance of us to have access. And we'll be doing this at Cubby's here in a few weeks. It'll be fun.
Can't wait.
No, it'll be a lot of fun. Coach, thank you. Thanks to all of you for joining us throughout the course of the season. And the last Monday of August, we'll have our first John Stiegelmeier radio show of the fall 2021 campaign. Keep an eye out for Jackrabbit softball in the NCAA tournament and all the things coming up Saturday, the Jackrabbit Athletic Scholarship Auction. If you can't be there in person, go to gojacks.com. You'll be able to watch it live as well. For Coach, I'm Tyler Merriam. We'll see you in the fall on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. We'll be right back.
The John Stiegelmeier Show, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original, and your Jackrabbit headquarters. Also brought to you in part by First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Believe in Possibility, Member FDIC, Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. First Bank and Trust, because everyone should play hard and bank easy. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. The preceding has been a Learfield IMG College presentation.